Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne, and today we're going to be doing pack 9 of the Agora Models release of build the Jaguar E-Type. Now before we go into exactly what's in this pack and stuff, I want to share with you the next book with photos by David Newhart, and it looks like this in the lovely red of the Jaguar we're actually building at the moment. This is something special and I'll show you why. Now, if you've been following along with Agora Models, you'll know that we got a book for the Shelby Super Snake and we got one for the Cobra. We've also got this one here, again, with the photos by David Newhart. And check out some of these pictures. They are absolutely amazing. Still get nervous when I look at these wheel rims. But I'm just going to give you a quick flick through. Not the whole book, just some select sections from the book here. But what particularly interests me about this one, which is absolutely great, this is going to look good on the shelf when I'm actually displaying this, is if I go right to the back, right to the very back, check that out. It's me next to the car we're building. And also, we've got Ian from Partwork Upgrades in here as well. We've actually made it famous into a hardback book. But these are absolutely brilliant. And once again, if you have subscribed to this, you will be getting this book later in the collection. So that's good. Now, talking about subscribing, if you want to subscribe to this model yourself, I have put the link down in the video description. You can get that all the way from pack one. Now, today, we're going to be doing the internals, the floor pan, a little bit more on the dashboard. We're also going to be installing the headlights into the bonnet. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So stage 65 here, it's all going to start with the glove compartment and grab handles. And just to jog your memory, this is what we were working on last time with the dashboard there. And obviously we need to put a glove box in here. And this is what the glove box looks like. Quite simply, this is just going to go over the top, just like that, sealing that all into place. And that's going to be held in with 2x AG06 screws, which I just so happen to have here. So we'll get these in. Now, I obviously saw the finished model when I went to Jaguar last year. I also saw the model again at the Goodwood Festival of Speed a couple of weeks ago. Looks pretty amazing, I have to say. And that's when I found out I'm actually in that book, which made me smile big time. But there we go. That's the glove box in place. Now we're going to be putting the top of the dashboard in place. This is a hard bit of plastic. This is just going to go on the two lugs that we can see there. So this is going to go on just like that. Once again, held in with the AG06 screws. So one in this side. Make that nice and tight. And then one in the other side here. Now, if you've probably noticed, my steering wheel's fallen off. Let me just put that back on. There we go. That's looking pretty good. Love it. So all we have to do then is just get the grab handle for the glove compartment here. And that's just going to go into this hole. And it's sort of going to go off to the side. So it's being very gentle as I put this in. It has got a semicircular hole, so it can only go in one way. And there we go. That's in just like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. So stage 66, as you can see here, we've got the rear floor and some screws. Bringing over what we'd done previously, which looks like that. Pretty impressive, isn't it? This is just going to be going this way around. Underneath. Going to turn this upside down so you can see. Being gentle, make sure we're not squashing that gear stick. I think we're good. And it's going to be going in that way there. And we're going to hold this in once again with 3 AG06 screws. So if I put the one in the middle first, that should hold that in, which will now make putting the other two in nice and simple. So that's the last one there. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 67, we have got the spare wheel and rear floor covers here. We've got the little spare wheel pull handle here. Tiny thing this is. And that's going to go into that little ingress we see there. Once again, it is a D-shaped pattern, so it can only go in one way. I'm going to push this in, just see if this is going to require any glue. It's not. That's gone in really tough. That's not going to fall out there at all. Okay, bring over what we just worked on. And this tray here is going to go just into the position like that, with the handle facing up towards this side here. Perfect. Now on top of that whole thing, we're going to be having the boot cover, which will just sit on like that for now. And that's all there is to do in that stage. We're whizzing through these stages at the moment. Now in stage 68, we've got the fuel tank top and base. And the first thing we need is the part which looks just like this. And we're going to be putting the fuel tank top in here. It's got a pin, so it's just a case of pushing this in here like that. The fuel pump is just going to be going into the holes below it, and again this is a push in, so that clips in just like that there. But to hold that in on the other side here, we are just going to be putting a AG06 screw. I've still got one of them left over from last time, so I'm not going to open another one. Just secure that tight. You can see that pin just went through there. Then we're going to be putting the pipe, the filler pipe in. Now that's going to go just on this section here. Again, it has got a shaped pattern. So it's going to go in, oops, get this round and in like that. And that's going to be held in once again with an AG04 screw. A lot smaller screw this is, so you really do want to make sure you have got a screwdriver which is A, got a long shaft, and B, has got a shaft thick enough that can go through there. If you're using something too big, you're not going to be able to get that in there. There we go, that's the fuel filler pipe in place. And with those two bits there, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 69, we have got the left rear wheel arch. Now once again, we've got the fuel filler cap here, just opening that up, and that's just going to go into the recess that we can see on that area there. We've got a keyhole pattern, so it's just a case of rotating this round, lining it up, and then on the other side here we're just going to hold that in with a screw. That's one of the AG04 screws like we had last time, the really small ones, looking like that. We'll get that in there. Perfect. Bring across the floor pan like we had last time. Now you will notice I have taken those parts out because obviously as we're flipping it over, I don't want them falling out. This is actually going to go on this side here. So it is actually going, if you look at the top camera, just slotting under on those two points there. Once again, that's held in with the AG04 screws that we've just been using. So get this loaded up. And I'll put one in this side first, I think. Okay, excellent. And then just one at the back here. It's amazing how quick this goes together. And there we go, that one's in place as well. And that is all there is to do in that stage. And in a very similar fashion to what we've just done, you guessed it, we've got the right wheel arch. This time we haven't got any details to put in this, but what we do have to do, once again, bring over the floor pan, spin it round, because we're working on this side now, and in exactly the same way of what we've just done, this is just going to go on like that there. So, got me screws, I don't have to open another screw pack, I've still got plenty of these left over from previous stages. This time I think I'll put the front one in first. I haven't put that in too tight. It's tight enough to keep that in place while I put the rear one in. Perfect. And as you can see, that is what that's looking like. And that's what it looks like on the side camera. That's all there is to do in that stage. So, you thought things were relatively easy then. Now it's time to get a little bit tricky, because we're going to be doing the headlights. Okay, so to start off with, we're going to need the headlight reflector looking like this. This one's got an L on it, so we know that it's the left-hand side one. And we're going to be putting one of these lenses over the top. Now, the lens has got a notch just down the bottom, and there is a notch just into the recess here. So I'm going to match them up, and that's going to go on just like that. But I do need to glue that into place. So I have already got some glue lined up, which I'm just going to put into that recess at the bottom there. I think that should be enough to hold that in, seeing how sturdy that was in on its own. So I'm just finding the notch again, lining that up, and pushing that together. And there we go. That's one headlight completed there. We're going to do exactly the same with the other side. So we've got the left-hand side, and as you can see here, the right-hand side. Now, basically, I've brought down the partwork upgrades mat here because I want to protect these as much as I can. And what we're going to do is we're going to be taking the left-hand side lens and the left-hand side scope, and we're going to be putting this in into the inside here. So let me just match this off with the lugs. They're going to go in this way, like this. Just lining it up from this side over here. And that looks just about perfect there. Now, to keep that into place there, we have got the back mount, which looks like that. That's going to go on this way, over the top, and push that in. And then that's going to be held in with these silver screws, which come in this stage. Put these in, one in this side. Perfect. And then just one in the other side here. So, show you what that looks like, just like that, and we're going to do the same on the other side. And there you go, they're both of those completed. We don't actually put the LEDs in these ones at the moment, so that is all there is to do in this stage. Now, in stage 72 here, some pretty impactful pieces, we've got the right front wing. And the LED here is for the indicator. So let's get this wing out. Looking good. And the indicator, which looks like that. Pretty impressive. That's just going to go on this way like that here. And it's held in from the other side. I'm being really gentle here with some AG04 screws. So I just need two of them on here. I should probably be using my partwork upgrades mat, but I'm being very gentle. I have now decided to bring up the partwork upgrades mat because we need the bonnet now that we had, stage 23. And I haven't even taken this out. As you can see, that is what it looks like there. Really, really nice looking. Check that out. Perfect. So we're going to be taking the right headlight now, looking like this. Got the R on it. We're just going to be putting the little gap there in between the cavity of the frame here. Just trying to explain how that is, so that fits flat. Now we're going to be taking the wing. You can see now why I wanted to make sure that this is all protected. And that's just going to go over these points here. So I'm going to clip everything together, slotting this into the other side here, just like that. Perfect. Now they're going to be held in with AM19 screws, and they look just like this. So I'm going to put one in the middle here first, just to hold that together. I haven't done it too tight so far. I'm going to put one by the lens. And that will keep that lens in. Then I can put the other two in this side. And then finally, just the other one on the headlight. So all in total, that's five of those screws. Now we've just got to put one more in here, which is an AG11 screw. Now once again, this is a silver screw. But this one's made for plastic. So this is just going in here. And that will keep that section together. So that looks like that. Pretty impressive, huh? Okay, keep that over this way. And we want to take the LED from last time that we had, and this one's labeled number 6. And that's going to go into the end of the headlight. I'm going to push that in. Just like that. Should fit perfectly in there. And then from this stage here, we need the indicator light. This one's labeled number 7. And that's just going to go into the indicator over this side here. Get that pushed in as far as we can get it. We don't want that falling out. I will straddle this with my tweezers and then push that in like that. And then eventually this is going to channel with this wire down just like that. But that is all there is to do in that stage. And that looks absolutely brilliant. So for the last stage, this is stage 73, we're going to do exactly the same thing. So this time, once again, we have got the wing, but I'm going to turn this upside down, put the other headlight, the left-hand side headlight, into place. So it's going to go in here, just like that. Line that up. Excellent. Over the top of it, we've got the wing to put on. So that's going to go on here. Just line that up again with this section here, biting them together like this, holding in place with the AM19 silver screws. I almost forgot that I need to put the indicator on. Typical, isn't it? So I can put that in there. The indicator's obviously held in with the AG04 black screws, which I've got here. I should be able to still get them in. I'm hoping I can. Yeah, we can. That's cool. That almost put a dampener on things because this has been going so well. And this is the last silver screw to put in of the 19. Just going to make sure everything's tight here. And then we're just going to be taking one of the AG11 screws. I've still got one left over from the last stage. And that's just going to go into the front here. So I'll put that in. Excellent. So now, just from the front, looking at that, that looks good, doesn't it? And then we're just going to put the lights in again. So this time, we've got the light from last time. This is the headlight, and this one's labeled number 5. That's going to go in here. All the way in. And then number 7 is the indicator, which is going to go into the other side just here, just like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. That's all there is to do in that pack. And how impressive does that look? That looks great. You know what, this has got to be the thumbnail. Let me just hold the wires like this, and let's have the thumbnail, I don't know, like this. There you go, done the thumbnail. If you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down here in the video description to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. But I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.